everybody knows that fertility of your soil have nothing to do with adding fertilizers. In fact, it has everything to do with so-called humus, which is organic matter partially decomposed and full of microorganisms such as bacteria and fungi. So if you want to have a higher harvest and better fertility of your soil, then you need to ensure that your soils have higher content of humus. In this video, I will talk about three main ways of increasing fertility of your soil. The first one is a standard one, but it's not cheap. And then second and third, unfortunately, are not that popular, but they're absolutely free and they build fertility of your soil every time for years to come. Easiest and most known way of increasing fertility of your soil is adding compost. Compost is actually already this decomposed manure or decomposed plants, any organic matter that went through this partial or full process of composting using different mechanisms, including microorganisms. You can buy compost, but it's not that cheap, and you can add it to your soil. Some people add compost to their garden beds every year. Some people even remove the old soil and add compost. So indeed, this way you can immediately increase the fertility of your soil, but it's not optimal. First of all, because it's expensive. Unless you produce your compost yourself, then it takes a lot of money. And secondly, it's not sustainable. Thirdly, it requires a lot of effort to bring compost, to add it to bed every year. So while you may consider this, and many people do, I would recommend other methods which are more user-friendly and cheaper, even completely free. The second way, which I talk about in some of my videos, is mulching. Mulching is adding organic matter, mostly something like glass clippings, straw, hay, leaves, sawdust to your soil. On the top of it, a few centimeters, when you grow plants, mulching prevents evaporation of water from soil and ensures that there is a better living conditions for your microorganism in the soil. And as a result, you actually get this decomposting process right in your soil. So where the soil and those microorganisms meet with your mulch, this process of converting your organic matter in humus starts. And the more microorganisms, the better fertility of your soil, the faster it happens. So the more mulch you add, the better fertility of the soil you have. And in fact, it's absolutely the same process that happens when you make compost, but it happens directly in your soil while in the meantime you are already growing your crops or your fruits and vegetables. So in my opinion, mulching is a really almost free, or can be free if you have some mulch grown in your garden, way of increasing fertility of your soil while growing harvests already. And the third method, which also builds the fertility of your soil, is growing green manure. First of all, in order to prevent erosion, which is actually a removal of all these fertile components of soil from the soil and leaching it out, so removal of that should be prevented. And in order to do that, you need to ensure that you never have bare soil. If you look, for example, in forests, the soil there is very fertile, but nobody adds any fertilizers there. The reason it's fertile is because it's always covered with plants, so there is no soil erosion, and then these plants are dying and being decomposed right there so that they become food for next plants. This is something that you need to encourage in your garden as well, especially considering that you grow crops or fruits and vegetables that take a lot of nutrients of the soil with them. as your tomato, for example, as you harvest. So you need to ensure that you add those nutrients back to the soil, right? And you cannot add them by adding inorganic fertilizers, just because they are not humus and they don't have everything that your plants need for them. So when you grow green manure, what happens is that those roots grow very deep in the soil, and they get those nutrients from deep in the soil, and they bring them to the plant. And then you cut this plant and you leave it in your garden in the soil, so all these nutrients, when this organic matter decomposts, again become new food, new nutrients for your harvest. So if you use those two last methods all the time, so you never have bare soil, but soil which covers with green manure if you are not growing your harvests. And then when you grow your harvests, you mulch, so that the process of creating humus ongoing all the time in your soil, with time you will get extremely fertile soil. Now, how long will it take? It depends on already level of your soil. So if you already have a lot of microorganisms, that would happen very quickly. In any case, within one season, you will definitely see a difference in your soil. Try to use half of at least one garden bed which you mulch and where you grow green manure, and compare that soil with your other garden beds. You will see that probably in a couple of months already you see a huge difference, and in 1-2 years you would never be able to recognize your soil, and you'll get huge harvests without any additional money input and with a very limited work input, just growing those green manure and mulching sometimes. To increase the fertility of your soil quite quickly, we can come back to compost. You don't have to put it all over the garden bed, just put it directly under the plant to save some of the money by buying compost. And also very free method of extracting organic nutrients from your plants, which you use for mulching, for example, is preparing a water solution of this. And I do have this video about how to prepare free nitrogen-containing fertilizer, but it's actually fertilizer that contains all the different necessary organic matter for your plants. So I do recommend you to watch it right now.